I knew him since 1977.
My voice
as a young Namibian who left the country to join the liberation struggle.
You will never see that.
It so happened that we went in the same year to Cuba.
Thank you very
much. And we started together, studying in Cuba. A football player, a kind man, an intelligent young person, with a great future. A very admirer of the Cuban Revolution, a very admirer of Comrade Fidel Castro, Che Guevara, and the entire leadership of the Cuban Revolution. So we, to us, Comrade Iyambo has departed too early. He had a great future to accomplish, particularly in the post-independence, in the fishery he did wonder. Everybody knows, not only Namibians, but the world, they know how efficient he was running the fishing industry. In education, he has set up a very strong, concrete basis of how to improve the education system in our republic.
I remember Abraham as a dynamic person,
a lot of
who
joy.
Loves children. He has been friend to everybody. He doesn't discriminate who has been friend of all of us. No one here in the group can call themselves that really they are friends of Abraham Iyambo, because he was just looking at us as a one group.
That smile, and then he will say, he's my brother,
friends,
he's my brother.
Sisters, and brothers.
Accept our sorrow, because this is a shared sorrow, but we should take solace in the life that is well lived and in the family.
I remember very well when we were selected to come to go and study in Cuba. We were told that we must be preparing ourselves for independent Namibia, and this is what we have been doing. And also, not only himself, but he was also a mentor of others, mentoring them to actually come and play this role of building and constructing a new Namibia, a new society, contributing to the formation of a new man, a new kind of Namibian that is actually going to take Namibia to further heights.
We were selected to be the first Namibian to go and study Spanish in order to prepare to go to Cuba. That was the time when we came to know each other, and this is a man who had principles since then, but and then it was enforced by the Cuban principles and how we were taught and so on. It's a great loss to the whole nation. The man died in the line of duty, and he knows, and those are the principles which the Cuban government, when we studied there, they taught us that you need to work for your country.